There you go. Am I recording? Okay. When it says similarity ratio of the sides, this is page 24 in the similarity pack. Okay. When it says page 24, similarity ratio of the sides, what does that say? What am I asking for? Another word for that. Scale factor, right. All this means is the scale factor. So what's the scale factor? All right. Now, okay, that's what somebody asked me right there. They're like, why do you go little to big when it's big to little? It doesn't matter what you do. You just need to be consistent when you set up your proportions. So if I start by going big to little, then when I write all my ratios, I should have the big in the top and the little in the bottom. If I start with the little in the top and the big in the bottom, then you do the same thing with all your other ratios. So here it's saying, what is the similarity ratio of the sides? What page am I? This is page 24. So we skip page 23. We'll go back to page 23. Right? Because you guys already did this one. So let's just look at it. You guys didn't do it? So in the 5 minutes where I said, do number one, page 24, you didn't do it. Well, we're going to do it now. We're going to go back to page 23. Okay, so we're going to go reverse because I guess we were supposed to start on page 23. All right, here you go. Similarity ratio of the sides is what? What's the scale factor? We're going big to small. 10 to 2. 10. This marker's no good. 10 to 2, or what's the length? 25 to 5. 10 to 2, 25 to 5. In either case, if we put that in lowest terms, we get 5 to 1. 5 to 1 is our scale factor. SF, scale factor. So it says that they're similar. We wrote the similar ratio, the scale factor. Then I ask you to find the area. Area of a rectangle is length times width. So the area of this rectangle is 10. The area of this rectangle is 250. So 10 and 250 are the areas. Then I'm asking you, what are the ratio of the areas? And let's go big to little again. Again, staying consistent. The area of the big rectangle is 250. The area of the little rectangle is 10. Well, let's put that in lowest terms. Reduce the fraction. That's 25 to 1. So this is the ratio of the areas. Now, what does this mean? Here's our scale factor. It's 5 to 1. Here's our ratio of the areas. Can you see a relationship? Okay. Let's just leave that there for a second. Leave that there. Right? There's a new right there. There's another one. Right? This is 7. This is 3. This is 14. This is. You think that's how it would work? Because you can't do a ratio here and here. So, well, I'm trying to just make up an example so you can see that better. So let me do something else, ready? I do like the 3. Yeah. So this is about the example I used last one was the one that I'll be using, but then what happens is when you go to the problem in when you have your own problems, it's like the same question. So then I was like, oh shoot, when you have a problem, you know, you want to do a different example than the one that I'm giving you later. So you actually have to use your brain. So now I'm just trying to like on the spot make up a problem that I know is gonna work. So but I don't want it to be a have a one in it. You know, I don't want part of the scale factor to be a one. You know what I mean? Like this scale factor is 5 to 1. I want it to be like 2 to 4 something. I know that's 1 to 2. So right? You get my problem? So here, like we can go 2 to 5, but like that's multiplying by 2.5. So ready? So now I gotta go like 8. What's 8 times 2.5? 16. 24, 8 plus 16 and 4, 20. All right, there we go. Boom. Okay. There we go. Yeah, I just made it. Yeah, that's what goes on in my head when I make that problem. 96. Okay. You guys are cool. Crazy. I know. All right. What's the scale factor? Okay. So now, I mean, we can go big to small. You can go small to little. Small to big. It doesn't matter. Right, as long as you're consistent. So the scale factor, is it 2 to 5? Mm-hmm. 2 to 5, is that the same thing as 8 over 20? How do you know? Cross multiply, if you get the same thing, that means it's a proportion. So that's not the scale factor. The scale factor is when you put it in lowest terms. 2 over 4. So 8 over 20 is also 2 over 5. Okay, cool, scale factor. Scale factor. Am I on the screen? Yes. Okay. Now let's find the areas. What's the area of this rectangle? What's the area of this rectangle? 100. So 16 to 100 is the ratio of the areas. Put 16 over 100 in lowest terms. 8 over what? 8 over 50 could still go lower. 4 over 25. So 4 over 25 is the ratio of the areas. Now don't say anything out loud. Just observe. Scale factor, 5 to 1. Ratio of the areas, 25 to 1. Scale factor, 2 to 5. Ratio of the areas, 4 to 25. How do you get from 5 to 1 to 25 over 1? How do you get from 2 to 5 to 4 over 25? Now you can say it. What did you say? Elisa? What are we doing? Multiplying it by itself, another word for that is squaring it, right? Something squared, you multiply it by itself. If you take 2/5 and you square it, right? 2, because I don't want to get marker on myself. You know how many times I've dropped the marker and it hits me and it ruins my clothes? 2 squared is 4. 5 squared is 25. Yeah, what the heck, Oriana? Sorry. 2 to 5. 2. So this whole time I've been over here, they haven't been able to see it. Oh, it's okay. It makes the video more entertaining. Okay, so for those of you out there in the metaverse, this is what happened. Is that what it's called now, right?
No, it's just called
it's still called the internet. What's the metaverse? Oh, that's Facebook. What's it called?
Just say it's
those of you guys out there in the cloud. We found, I made up these two rectangles right here, right? So we found, I made up those lengths, but I made them so they were similar. So 8 over 20 and 2 over 5 are the same, right? So that's the scale factor. Then we found the areas of both of those. 2 times 8 is 16, 5 times 20 is 100. We took the ratio of the areas and we reduced it. So the ratio of the areas is 4 to 25. The scale factor is 2 to 5. So we observed, if you take 2 squared, you get 4. If you take 5 squared, you get 25. So the ratio of the areas is found by squaring the scale factor. Okay? So if the ratio of the areas is A to B, sorry, if the scale factor is A to B, then what's the ratio of the areas? A squared to B squared. Now, when you're finding a missing area, you use the ratio of the areas. Just like when we found a missing side in a similar polygon, you use the ratio of the sides. Okay? All right, so now we're going to look at example 2. Oh, yeah. Let's erase all this junk. All right. Ready? What's the ratio of the areas? Well, in order to find the ratio of the areas, we need to use the sides. The scale factor is 13 over 9.1. So then what is the ratio of the areas? What are we going to do with this to get this? I'm just doing number A first. I'm finding the ratio of the areas. I'm not finding any missing area yet. You can't find the missing area unless you have the ratio of the areas or the sides. How's the conversation going? You guys learning a lot of geometry? That's the scale factor.
Yeah.
What's the ratio of the areas? Okay, I remember just writing over here. Push. I remember writing over here SF, right? And we wrote A to B. And then I wrote ratio of the areas. What did we say? Yes. 13 squared. Over 9.1 squared. 13 squared is 169. 9.1 squared is 82.81. Now, I also said if you're finding a missing area, you need to use the ratio of the areas. This is now the ratio that we're going to use in our proportion. 169 over 82.81 equals big to little, area of the big, big of the middle. Now we can cross multiply and solve for x. 169x equals 2900. Now, we're talking about area, and area is in square units, so these are centimeters squared. while I'm saying it. But if you're at home, you can watch. You can see it. Yeah, if you make it big, you can see it. All right. Okay, we're going to come back to this because we were supposed to do page 23 before we did 24. Now we're going back to page 23. So I'll go back to page 23. And we're going to be doing the same thing except for perimeters. So answer the questions here. Take about 2 minutes and then we'll discuss. All right, ready? Stop. Why is 4 to 10 not the similarity ratio? Amada? They're both in this rectangle, right? I mean, 4 to 10 is a ratio, but 4 to 10 is the ratio of the width to the length. When we're setting up a similarity ratio, it's got to be the corresponding sides of this one to this one. So we've got the width of this one to the width of this one. The width of this one is 2. The width of this one is 4. So 2 to 4, put that in lowest terms, that's 1 to 2. That's our scale factor, 1 to 2. Now, I told you they're similar. You use the scale factor to find missing sides. You use the ratio of the areas to find missing areas. That's what we did in the last example. Now, we want to find a missing side. Well, 1 to 2, small to big, 1 to 2 equals, we don't know the length, we do know the length. 1 to 2 is the ratio of the sides, write the ratio of the lengths, cross multiply, 2L equals 10, the length equals 5. So our missing side is 5. Now I ask you to find the perimeters. Perimeter, add up all the sides. What's the perimeter of a small rectangle? 14. What's the perimeter of a large rectangle? 28. Add up all the sides. What's the ratio of the perimeters? 14 to 28. Which is 1 to 2. The scale factor is 1 to 2. The ratio of the perimeters is 1 to 2. Let's see if we can make this complete. They're the same. All right. The rate, the scale factor ratio of the perimeters is the same. I mean, perimeters is length. It's adding everything up. Side of length, right? So the perimeter ratio of the perimeters is the same as the scale factor. Okay? So if the ratio of the perimeters is A to B, what's the ratio of the areas? It's the square, right? Because you square the scale factor. Right? The perimeters is A to B. The scale factors is A to B. The ratio of the areas is A squared to B squared. You square the scale factor. Okay? All right. What does it mean? Down there at the bottom, they're the same. Now, here we go. Last example, then we'll do a couple on your own. Because it's like my mother, if I switch to the board, there's a... You know what kids used to do back in the day when you had chalkboards? Like the erasers, you like, it'd be like split, like there like three different erasers in one, and it would stick a piece of chalk in there. So then you would take the eraser and go like this, and then actually go on the board. Good morning, Mr. Sobolski. Can you show the board? You know, put it in it, but that was fine. So basically, like a piece of chalk would stick in the eraser, so then you'd go, so then you go to erase the board, and you go like this. Dude, I've been teaching for like 8 6 years. What? The sound of like even the eraser on the chalkboard. Yeah, like, the dust would get all over the place. I literally would have like chalk dust all over my hands. It was green. They were all green. Some places are black, right? And that's the brightest, better contrast. So it was green, and we would use like yellow and white chalk.
That's really good.
And the chalk would break. And you know how I always do this? The time for when I do that to try to make it, I would do that with the chalk. When the chalk would hit, and then chalk all over the place. And then the next teacher would come in and yell mad because there was a big chalk mess on the ground. What is the similar ratio? Hold on. Let me scroll up. All right. Similarity ratio. So again, similarity ratio is scale factor. What's the scale factor? 10 to 50, put it in lowest terms. 1 to 5, or 5 to 1 if you're going big to little, doesn't matter. Okay. Well, if that's the scale factor, then what's the ratio of the perimeters? Same thing. The ratio of the perimeters is also 1 to 5. It's the same as the scale factor. So if the ratio of the perimeters is 1 to 5, the perimeter of the bigger triangle is 100. We need to know the perimeter of the smaller one. So we don't even need to know all the side lengths. We just need to know the ratio of the sides and the perimeter of one. Now cross multiply. 5x equals 100. X equals 1. So use the ratio of the perimeters to find the missing perimeter. Use the ratio of the areas to find the ratio of the areas. How is all that related? Well, let's write it again. This is the bottom of page 24. If the similar ratio is, should we use one of the letters besides A to B? Let's do what?
Yeah.
then the ratio of the perimeters is M to N. Then the ratio of the areas is N squared to N squared. Alright. You're going to do two on your own. And it's only two example problems. We've only got like 6 or 7 minutes left. Go to page 25. There you go. There's your two problems that you're going to practice. Go.